if you saw care to join in the verses. It was, let's say, verse 1 at the entrance, verse 2 during the offertory, and verse 3 recession. And am I encouraging you to sing? Technically speaking, no. Am I giving you subliminal messages there? Maybe so. God forgive me. But it's just so difficult to worship God, my mind, without singing. So you use your conscience however you want in terms of chiming in. Right? So we'll be. Thank you all for having. When I start walking closer to you, I your body language. Some of you start going like this, away from me. I apologize. Let me get this away from you. It's good to see this couple in the front row. Yes, usually your spot is over there, right? Yes, maybe. But I've been thinking of the two of you a lot because I haven't seen you. Is this the first time you come in 5 months? No.
No.
Okay. It's okay. It would be okay. It would be okay.
We've been watching on YouTube.
You're what?
We've been watching the mass on YouTube.
Oh, okay, okay. But personally, physically, is the first time?
No.
No, I'm not here.
Okay,
not
in here. All right. Thank you. Okay. So donations have been trickling in for the festival, like I announced last Sunday. So last Sunday, between two communities, Immaculate Conception and Good Shepherd, we had collected 12,000. That for coronavirus times is not bad, even though it's much lower than it would have been had we had the festival. But if you haven't yet, please, if you're in a position to help out, do so. And today's special collections is for the shrines of the Holy Land, like it was announced last Sunday. So there are two baskets there, that's why. The first one for the parish needs, and the second one would be for the shrines of the Holy Land. Also, I want to take this opportunity to thank the Altar Society, ladies of the Altar Society in the parish. For a good while, they have been paying for the host and the wine, okay, in the parish. At my request, they accepted humbly, I don't want to say grudgingly, but humbly, and I want to say gratefully, because if there's one expense that is worth incurring into, is to pay for what is going to become the body and blood of Jesus Christ. So what a privilege. So if you know of any ladies of the Altar Society, please do thank them for their generosity. Over there, I see we have proper distancing here. Yes. And behind you, where you just came in, do you mind stepping up here a little bit more? I know you were there first. You were here first, right?
Yeah, I'm over here.
Okay, so okay, so first nickety. Okay, you all okay there? Any questions, comments, suggestions?
Okay.
Let us stand up and begin the worship.
Who will bear my mind to me?
grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, coming together as God's family with confidence, let us ask the Father's forgiveness, for he is full of gentleness and compassion.
Lord Jesus, you came to reconcile us to one another and to the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you heal the wounds of sin and division. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you intercede for us with your Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest,
and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Let us pray. Look upon us, O God, Creator and Ruler of all things, and that we may feel the working of your mercy. Grant that we may serve you with all our heart. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Sirach. Wrath and anger are hateful things, yet the sinner hugs them tight. The vengeful will suffer the Lord's vengeance, for he remembers their sins in detail. Forgive your neighbor's injustice, then when you pray, your own sins will be forgiven. Can anyone nourish anger against another and expect healing from the Lord? Could anyone refuse mercy to another like himself? Can he seek pardon for his own sins? If one who is but flesh cherishes wrath, who will forgive his sins? Remember your last days. Set enmity aside. Remember death and decay and cease from sin. Think of the commandments. Hate not your neighbor. Remember the Most High's covenants and overlook faults. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord is kind and merciful, slow to anger and rich in compassion. The Lord is kind and merciful, slow to anger and rich in compassion.
Bless the Lord, O my soul. And all my being, bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits.
The Lord is kind and merciful, slow to anger and rich in compassion.
He pardons all your iniquities. fulfills. He redeems your life from destruction, crowns you with kindness and compassion.
The Lord is kind and merciful, slow to anger and rich in compassion.
He will not always chide, nor does he keep his wrath forever. Not according to our sins does he deal with us, nor does he requite us according to our crimes.
The Lord is kind and merciful, slow to anger and rich in compassion.
For as the heavens are high above the earth, so surpassing is his kindness towards those who fear him. As far as the east is from the west, so far has he put our transgressions from us.
The Lord is kind and merciful, slow to anger and rich in compassion.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, none of us lives for oneself. No one dies for oneself. For if we live, we live for the Lord. And if we die, we die for the Lord. So then, whether we live or die, we are the Lord's. For this is why Christ died and came to life, that he might be Lord of both the dead and the living. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I say to you, not seven times, but 77 times. That is why the kingdom of heaven may be likened to a king who decided to settle accounts with his servants. When he began the accounting, a debtor was brought before him who owed him a huge amount. Since he had no way of paying it back, his master ordered him to be sold, along with his wife, his children, and all his property in payment of the debt. At that, the servant fell down and did homage and said, "Be patient with me, and I will pay you back in full." Moved with compassion, the master of that servant let him go and forgave him the loan. When that servant had left, he found one of his fellow servants who owed him a much smaller amount. He seized him and started to choke him, demanding, "Pay back what you owe." Falling to his knees, his fellow servant begged him, "Be patient with me, and I will pay you back." But he refused. Instead, he had the fellow servant put in prison until he paid back the debt. When his fellow servants saw what had happened, they were deeply disturbed and went to their master and reported the whole affair. His master summoned him and said to him, "You wicked servant, I forgave you your entire debt because you begged me to. Should you not have had pity on your fellow servant as I had pity on you? Then in anger, his master handed him over to the torturers until he should pay back the whole debt. So will my heavenly Father do to you, unless each of you forgives your brother from your heart. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
So I want to give you a quick synopsis of the reading from Sirach and today's Gospel. And a quick synopsis is this. Forgiveness. It's a state of radical change. Well, before we get too serious about this Gospel, I'm going to ask you a math question. So I know all you are awake and you have your math skills finely tuned to answer my question. At least to think about it. Once there was a businessman who wanted to hire a new employee. He devised a simple test to screen potential employees. He asked the first applicant, who was an accountant, how much is 2 plus 2? He replied, the answer is exactly 4, actually 4.0. The second applicant, he asked, and the second applicant, by the way, was an engineer, he asked the same question. The applicant applied several math formulas, used his calculator, and replied, the answer is 4.00193. The third applicant was a lawyer. When asked the same question, the lawyer thought a moment and then asked, how much do you want it to be? And I would submit to you that the lawyer's response comes closer to the correct answer to the question raised in today's Gospel. How often must I forgive? No, Peter's answer is more like the answer given by the accountant and the engineer. It was carefully calculated, it was very defined and very limited. Had Peter been thinking like the lawyer, he would have said, what do you want the answer to be, Lord? Because the Lord's answer implies an infinite number. You know, our forgiveness has to be unlimited because God's mercy is unlimited. By forgiving without limit, we join in God's creative activity of bringing mercy to the world. It is truly a joy to forgive from the heart. Note, I did not say that it is fun, nor did I say it is a pleasure. Forgiveness is hard. Forgiveness is difficult. And in many cases, forgiveness is very, very painful. Forgiveness is an interesting and very complex word for the human being. You know, by definition, I'm going to read the definition to you. It is the intentional and voluntary process by which a victim undergoes a change in feelings and attitude regarding an offense committed against him or her. And the victim overcomes the negative emotions such as resentment and vengeance. Now, forgiveness does not mean that you are not hurt. And forgiveness surely does not mean that you have to be friends with the person again. And forgiveness does not mean that you trust the person again. Forgiveness is not some type of emotional feeling. Forgiveness is a decision. Now, I want you to listen to the Our Father prayer that we will be saying here in just a few minutes. And I mean, really listen to this prayer that you are about to say. Because what you are saying is this: Lord, don't forgive me until I forgive the one who really hurt me. Forgiveness needs to be put in terms of justice. Now, in simple terms, justice is a means of balancing out what is owed to someone or what someone owes you. The difference is this: forgiveness is the amount of mercy that you apply to the debt that is owed to you. Essentially, what you are saying is that you will not make the person pay back what he owes, because God's grace has already fulfilled that debt in your heart. Today's gospel is a prime example of forgiveness by the master. The servant was in so much debt that there was no way he could repay his master in 10 lifetimes. But the master, in a forgiving and merciful way, said, "You are forgiven. I release you from your total debt." Now, this forgiveness is coupled with justice, because the master was fully aware of exactly what the servant owed him. And don't you think that weighed on his mind? But in spite of this, he still released him. I'm sure that this took some kind of superhuman effort to not only say those words, but to really mean them in a way that assured there would be no retaliation. You see, it is with God's grace that all this is made possible. I'm not going to make you pay me back, because I am totally relying upon the strength and courage that God will give me. If we rely on ourselves, I'm not sure that the human condition is really that strong to put any meaning into those words. Those words, "You are forgiven." But with total reliance upon God, then this act becomes very realistic. Yes, I'm still hurt. But I am not anchored in my hurt or hatred, because I am still holding the person that hurt me by the throat until I am fully restored. I am fully satisfied. God helps me to release my feelings and allows his calmness to invade my soul. My grip on retribution is dissolved, it's forgotten, and both I and my debtor are absolved and forgiven. You know, forgiving others is not a sad task. It is joyful. It is not pleasurable. It is joyful. Joyful because we release God's mercy into a world badly in need of mercy. True forgiveness comes from the heart, because that's where God is. In the deepest, innermost part of our being is where we find God. And only God can forgive. When we tap into God's pool of mercy, which dwells in our hearts, then God's mercy flows out of us. God depends on us, for this important task. He's depending on us. Remember, only God can forgive, but only we can make it happen. Joy is the proof that we have forgiven from the heart. And I pray, Lord, help me to forgive others as you have forgiven me. Praise the Lord. For the church, her leaders, and all the faithful, that all will be blessed with wisdom and devotion, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For Christians in the Holy Land, by giving to today's special collection, we may become an instrument of peace, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For those who hold public office, they will imitate the goodness of God, who secures justice and the rights of the oppressed, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all those engaged in the work of education in the faith, and those returning to school, God will bless them, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Let those who are burdened by the weight of resentments, may they find solace in today's lessons of compassion and forgiveness, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For those who have gone before us, may they be rejoicing in eternal light, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Today we pray especially for Vicky Rodriguez, Paulina Kianis, Joseph Roberts, and Gloria Carrillo. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the well-being of Aurora Rodriguez, and for those who are struggling with health issues, and those recovering from surgery, or those that are undergoing surgery soon, for peace and trust, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
God of the living and the dead, you call believers to love one another. Do not hold our sins against us, but hear the prayers we offer. For we ask this through Christ.
Amen.
By the Lord of Stone and Grain, I have worn my people's pain. I have wept for mother and they turn away. I will break their hearts of stone, in a heart for love alone. I will speak my words to them. Whom shall I send?
Let us pray that this, my sacrifice and yours, may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord's sacrifice and the grace of the Lord's name for our good and all of the Lord's Church.
Look with favor on our supplications, O Lord, and in your kindness accept these, your servant's offering, that what each has offered to the honor of your name may serve the salvation of all. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Holy Father, Lord of heaven and earth, through Christ our Savior. For by your word you created the world, and you govern all things in harmony. You gave us the same word made flesh as mediator, and he has spoken your words to us, and called us to follow him. He is the way that leads us to you, the truth that sets us free, the life that fills us with gladness. Through your Son, you gather men and women whom you made for the glory of your name into one family. Redeemed by the blood of his cross and signed with the seal of the Spirit. Therefore, now and for ages unending, with all the angels, we proclaim your glory as in joyful celebration we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, and to be glorified, O God, who loved the human race, and who always walked with us on the journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son present in our midst when we are gathered by his love, and when, as once for the disciples, so now for us, he opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father most merciful, we ask that you send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, he took bread and said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, gave you thanks, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, Holy Father, as we celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Savior, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your right hand, we proclaim the work of your love until he comes again, and we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favor on the oblation of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us, and grant that by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. By our partaking of this mystery, Almighty Father, give us life through your Spirit. Grant that we may be conformed to the image of your Son, and confirm us in the bond of communion, together with Francis, our Pope, our Bishop Gustavo, Michael, his assistant, with all other bishops, with priests and deacons, and with your entire people. Grant that all the faithful of the church, looking into the signs of the times by the light of faith, may constantly devote themselves to the service of the gospel. Keep us attentive to the needs of all, that sharing their grief and pain, their joy and hope, we may faithfully bring them the good news of salvation and go forward with them along the way of your kingdom. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever. There, in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and martyrs, and with all the saints, we shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son.
through him and with him and in him. O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Only God can forgive, but we can make it happen. So we offer this prayer that Jesus taught us with heartfelt and honest mind.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace. With you.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. How precious is your mercy, O God. The children of men seek shelter in the shadow of your wings. Only two people, only one person is going to receive in their pew, and that's the gentleman here. Anybody else is? So, thank you. You want this handicap. Thank you.
Amen.
Thank you.
May the working of this heavenly gift, O Lord, we pray, take possession of our minds and bodies, so that its effect and not our own desires may always prevail in us, through Christ our Lord.
Amen. I'd like to thank Deacon for his homily. Those words, servants, stay with me. Only God can forgive, but only we can make it happen. So very true. And it shows a different twist, different insight. Thank you for the lecture from your name. Scott.
Kristen
Scott. Bless you. And Patrick Paul, thank you for also bearing the cross. That's the lightest cross you're ever going to bear in your life. And also the building thing is a very important part of the mass. So thank you, the choir, well, sort of the choir. I don't know about you, but I've been following the tennis, the U.S. Open tennis, and it was a delight to see the women's final last night. What a strategy this Japanese-American had, even though she never said that she on purpose played very low and slow the first set. There's no doubt in my mind. She said, I'm going to hit this ball all I can in the second and third set. She will see who I am, kind of. Not quite like that, but she's very tender-hearted and very good, woman. Naomi. Naomi, also Japanese. And then also tonight would be team. And Dominic. So, Dominic team. And the German. Now, what is a tennis fan here? Who's the German? Oh my goodness. Okay, I'll switch gears the next time. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. The Mass is ended. Let us go in peace. To love and serve the Lord by serving each other.
Thanks be to God.
Have a blessed week. And thank you all for singing. You sound very, very good. Bless you.
By the Lord be unfailing,
I will carry the poor
and lame,
I will
serve a need for them.